when everybody was afraid of the Germans, afraid of the Japs, but most of all afraid of a homeland attack. And that morning when Ken went out on the doormat, his world went black, cause right there, front page news, 3 weeks before 1942, Pearl Harbor's been bombed and the Japs are coming. Pictures of soldiers dying and running. Ken knew what it would lead to, just like he guessed. The president said the evil Japanese in our home country would be locked away. They gave Ken a couple of days to get his whole life packed in two bags. Just two bags, couldn't even pack his clothes. Some folks didn't even have a suitcase to pack anything in. So two trash bags is all they gave them. And when the kids asked Mom, where are we going, nobody even knew what to say to them. Ken didn't want to lie, he said the U.S. is looking for spies. So we have to live in a place called Mandanar, where a lot of Japanese people are. Ken got out big hopes of a normal life with his kids and his wife, but then they got back to their home and what they saw made him feel so alone. These people had trashed every room, smashed in the windows and bashed in the doors, written on the walls and the floor, Japs not welcome anymore. And Kenji dropped both of his bags at his sides and just stood outside. He looked at his wife without words to say. She looked back at him wiping tears away and said, someday we'll be okay, someday. Now the names have been changed, but the story's true. My family was locked up back in 42. My family was there where it was dark and damp, and they called it an internment camp.